And now, your storm shield forecast with NBC26 Chief Meteorologist Cameron Moreland.
With highs in the lower half of the 40s today, the December thaw continued, and it was the warmest day in 2 weeks. It will also be the warmest day for the rest of the year. Here's a look at your 7-day temperature trend. Much colder weather is coming back. We'll see lower 20s tomorrow, lower 30s Thursday and Friday, and then the frigid air starts to move in over the weekend. It'll be here by early next week with high temperatures struggling to reach zero. Right now, we are looking at mainly 30s across the area, lower 30s across the north, upper 30s across the south. In Appleton, with mostly clear skies, the temperature is 34 degrees, and it is still very windy. Westerly winds gusting to 30 miles per hour. In Green Bay, the winds are not quite as strong, but still gusty. It is 33 with westerly winds at around 10 to 20 miles per hour. With mostly clear skies, we've got dry weather across the area. As you can see on Storm Shield radar, there are some lake effect snow showers across the UP. All of that activity will stay to our north. We're watching a cold front move across the area right now. Earlier today, south of that front, it was warm. Temperatures were in the 30s, 40s, and 50s. North of it, it was only in the teens and 20s, and that's the colder weather that's going to move back in for tomorrow. In fact, many of us will see high temperatures about half of what we saw today, with lower to mid 20s. Sun and clouds early in the morning will give way to cloudy skies. Right now, it looks like the calm before the storm. So let's talk about that storm. Over the last week or so, the computer forecast models have been in pretty good agreement that we were going to get a snowstorm here in central and eastern Wisconsin with a solid 6 to 12 inches likely across the area. Today, everything changed. Those computer forecast models started to back way off on those totals, and here's the latest information right now. The American GFS model showing about 4 to 7 inches, the American NAM model showing about 1 to 3, and the European model is now showing about 1 to 2 inches. One of these forecasts may be correct, or they could all be wrong. By this time tomorrow, I'll have a much better idea. This is the way it looks right now. A strong area of low pressure will develop downwind of the Rockies by Thursday morning. It'll shift north and east during the day on Thursday, producing a widespread snow across the state. The snow will then continue into Friday, and this is where the new issues come up. The storm continues to track to the north and east as we head through Friday, but all of the Gulf moisture that was expected to get wrapped back into the storm over Wisconsin for Friday now looks like it's going to go to our east and miss us. So we're just going to have to wait and see. Here's what I want you to know right now. Accumulating snow is on the way. The big questions are still how much and where. Regardless, we're going to expect difficult traveling for Thursday and Friday with the snow moving through. And then behind this system, probably the bigger weather story, the frigid air moving in for early next week with high temperatures running 30 to as much as 35 degrees below normal for this time of year. So tonight, fair skies and colder, lows in the single digits and lower teens. Tomorrow, thickening clouds and much colder than today, no 40s. No 30s, we'll be in the 20s. Snow for Thursday and Friday. Highs will be in the lower 30s. Morning highs in the lower 20s on Saturday as that Arctic air starts to push in. On Sunday, look for a high right around 10, give or take about 5 degrees. Chance for some snow both Christmas Eve and on Christmas Day. Probably not much. The big story is going to be the frigid air. Highs around 0, give or take about 5 degrees on Christmas Day, and then struggling to hit 0 on Tuesday, Stacy. So, you know, when you're heading back to the store to maybe, you know, exchange a gift that you got, you're going to be running pretty quickly from the car to the shopping area.
You might just wait a while until it warms up a little bit and say, I'll just hang on to the receipt. Well, rescuing Christmas for